Hey everyone, my name is Danny Hill, and today I'm going to read to you one of my favorites, Danny and the Dinosaur. It's by Syd Hoff. He also does the illustrations in there. It's great. For those that don't know, my name is Danny, so this is a book that actually sticks pretty close to my heart because I always imagined myself as being Danny. And look, Danny rides around on top of a dinosaur and has a fun, crazy adventure. So I'm glad you're with me. Let's do it. Let's read Danny and the Dinosaur! But like a fun dinosaur. You ready? Okay, let's get into it. Here we go, the story. Uh-oh. What's that? This is an autograph, and I think every book should have one. Not of someone famous, but of someone that's important to me. And this person right here is the person that gave me this book. And this person right here is my very, 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 very favorite person in the whole wide world. And that person is, well, my mother. And she talks about how much she loves me here, and she says, enjoy it, and she bought it for my daughter. So here we go, Mom, reading the book for you and everyone else. Hopefully we like it. Here's the story, Danny and the Dinosaur. This is exciting. Okay, so now we're going to have to come over here. I'm going to have to do it from the side so you can see it. This is the story of Danny and the Dinosaur. Page one, this is a very fun one. This one's all about Danny. One day, Danny went to the museum. He wanted to see what was inside. What do you think was inside that museum? Well, I don't know. Let's go in. Let's figure it out. Here we go. Let's see. Inside the museum, he saw Indians, he saw bears, he saw Eskimos, he also saw guns, he saw swords, and then he saw... What do you think he saw? Let's think about it. What do you think Danny saw inside the museum? Well, the book is called Danny and the Dinosaur. We have Danny. We don't have the dinosaur yet. Maybe it's the dinosaur. Let's see. Let's look it up. Something is there. What did Danny see? A dinosaur! That's right. He saw a dinosaur. Danny loved dinosaurs. He really, really wished he had one. Oh, he wanted one so bad. Maybe we could wish with him. Who wants to wish with me? Okay, let's wish together. I wish Danny had a dinosaur. I wish Danny had a dinosaur. I wish Danny had a dinosaur. What? Something's going on here. I'm sorry, they're not real, said Danny. It would be nice. Wouldn't it be nice to have your own dinosaur to play with? Well, yeah. And I think it would be nice to play with you. Who said that? Well, it was a dinosaur, said the voice. Can you, said Danny? Who? It was the dinosaur that said that. Can this dinosaur play with Danny? Well, as it turns out, he can. He can. Yes, said the dinosaur. Oh, good, said Danny. What can we do? What would you do with a dinosaur? Well, he says, I can take you for a ride, said the dinosaur. He put his head down so Danny could get on him. Look at that. Dinosaur bending over to get him on there, and Danny's jumping on, and look how happy the dinosaur is. All right. Well, what would you do with a dinosaur? Just about anything you could. Let's go, said Danny. There they go. Bong, 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 bong. What? A policeman stared at them. He had never seen a dinosaur stop for a red light. Never! Look at him! He's in awe! Ooh! It gets better, though. What else is Danny going to do with the dinosaur? Well, Danny and the dinosaur was so tall, Danny had to hold up the ropes for him. See, look, all the clotheslines. He's holding up the ropes. Oh, no! Look out, said Danny. The rope still got twisted in his neck. Oh, no, the dinosaur! Woo! They made it out okay on that one. Bow, wow, wow! Said a dog running after them. He thinks you're a car, said Danny. Go away, dog! We're not a car! Look at that dog. He thinks he's a car, but he's not a car, he's a dinosaur. Oh, there's Danny just loving on that dinosaur. I can make a noise like a car, said the dinosaur. Honk! Honk, honk, honk! Honk, honk! Doesn't sound like a car, though, does it? one's good. "What big rocks!" said the dinosaur.
"Wow, they're not rocks," said Danny. "They're buildings."
"I love to climb," said the dinosaur. "Down, boys," said Danny. "Whoa, it's scary up there. I need you to get down."
It's hard to control a dinosaur.
The dinosaur had to be very careful not to knock over houses or stores with his long tail. Look at his tail. It's coming around buildings, coming up over here. There's a bus stop. Some people were waiting for the bus. They rode on the dinosaur's tail instead. They didn't know. They weren't paying attention.
Sometimes adults don't pay attention, and they should. But don't worry, that's not all.
"All who want to cross the street may walk on my back," said the dinosaur.
And look at all the people walking across the dinosaur's back having a good time. Isn't that awesome? Having so much fun.
"Well, it's very nice of you to help me with my bundles," said the lady.
Aw, they were walking the lady with the bundles.
That's not all they did. They saw movies, they saw candy, they saw the downtown area. Danny and the dinosaur went all over town and had lots of fun. "It's good to take an hour or two off after 100 million years, said the dinosaur.
And there he is, smiling, enjoying himself downtown.
They even looked at the ball game. "Hit the ball," said Danny. "Hit a home run," said the dinosaur. Look at him yell. "Batter, batter, we need you to hit one. Let's hit the ball."
Huh. I can't think of any good baseball phrases. Can you think of any?
Pitcher, pitcher, not a belly itcher?
I don't know.
The dinosaurs kept going on with Danny. "I wish we had a boat. Look at that," said Danny.
"Who needs a boat? I can swim."
Toot, toot, went the boats. Toot, toot, went Danny and the dinosaur. "Oh, what a lovely green grass this has," said the dinosaur. "I haven't eaten any of that for a very, very, very long time." "Wait," said Danny. "See what it says? Please keep off."
And we all know the rules. If there's a sign that says we can't do something, or if an adult tells us not to do something, we probably shouldn't do it because there's probably a good reason for it. Maybe it's not safe. So they decided to go get ice cream instead. And there's the ice cream truck and the ice cream man.
Yay! They went and had a good time. "Let's go to the zoo and see the animals," said Danny. "Look how happy he is to see the animals." Well, everybody came running to see the dinosaur. They're finally noticing the dinosaur. "Hey guys, I'm a dinosaur." Nobody stayed to see the lions.
Aww.
Nobody stayed to see the elephants. How sad they are. Nobody stayed to see the monkeys. "What, I'm a monkey?" Everybody left. And nobody stayed to see the seals, the giraffes, the hippos. Everybody's leaving. Where are they going? "Please go away so the animals will get looked at," said the zoo man, yelling at the dinosaur. "Let's find my friend," said Danny. "Very well," said the dinosaur.
They gotta take off because they're no longer wanted over there. It's pretty mean. That guy's pretty mean. They're just trying to have fun at the zoo. But he is an adult, so we have to do what he says. So there it is.
"There they are," said Danny. "Why, it's Danny riding on a dinosaur," said a child. "Maybe he'll give us a ride." May we have a ride, said the children. "I'd be delighted," asked the dinosaur. "Hold on tight," said Danny. And look at the kids riding on a dinosaur, going up and sliding down, having a good time. "Would you be able to ride on a dinosaur?"
"I don't know if I could. I'd be scared."
Well, around and around the block ran the dinosaur, faster and faster. "This is better than a merry-go-round," the children said. Look at him go. Run, 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 around, around, around. The dinosaur was out of breath. "Oh, teach him tricks," said the children. "Teach him a trick." Danny taught the dinosaur how to shake hands. "Can you roll over onto your back?" asked the children. Look, he's shaking hands. He's relaxing there. Well, let's see if he can roll on his back. He can!
That's easy, said the dinosaur. He's smart, said Danny, patting the dinosaur's belly. Let's play hide and seek, said the children. How do you play it, said the dinosaur. We hide, and you try to find us, said Danny. Okay, the dinosaur is happy. He wants to play. The dinosaur closed his eyes.
Okay, I'm gonna count.
There he is. All the children left to go hide. They ran to hide, and look at the kids hiding. Where are they gonna hide? Somewhere behind the tree, somewhere behind the bushes, somewhere behind a trash can. The dinosaur can't see him. The dinosaur looked and looked, but he couldn't find the children. I give up, he said. Where are you? Well, now it was the dinosaur's turn to hide. The children covered their eyes, and the dinosaur took off. The dinosaur hid behind a house, and the children found him. Oh, he's hiding. The dinosaur hid behind a sign, and the children found him. And that sign's an important sign. It says, brush your teeth every day, and you should always brush your teeth. Because when you brush your teeth, you're able to keep them clean, and then you're able to get stuff out of there. It's a good message right there from the dinosaur. He hid behind a big gas tank. The children found him. They found him again and again and again. There's the dinosaur. We can see him. Ah, oh, I guess there's no place for me to hide, cried the dinosaur. Let's make believe we can't find him, said Danny. Ooh, that'll be fun. Now, what they're doing is they're pretending not to see the dinosaur, so that way the dinosaur doesn't feel left out, which is a good thing to do. Sometimes you don't want people to feel left out. Where can he be? Where, oh, where is the dinosaur? Where did he go? Well, we give up. We can't find him. And if you look, you can tell the children should obviously be able to see him, but they're playing along. Here I am, said the dinosaur. Look at how happy the dinosaur is. The dinosaur wins, said the children. We couldn't find him. He fooled us all. They're laughing, throwing hats in the air, clapping their hands, having a good time. Hooray for the dinosaur, the children cried. Hooray, hooray. It got late, and the other children left. Danny and the dinosaur were alone. Well, goodbye, Danny, said the dinosaur. Can't you come stay with me, said Danny? We could have fun. No, said the dinosaur. I've had a good time, the best I've had in 100 million years. But now I must get back to the museum. They need me there. Oh, said Danny. Well, goodbye. And there they are saying goodbye. And here we go. What's going to happen next? Saying goodbye, he's walking away. Danny watched until the long tail was out of sight. Then he went home. There's Danny walking home. He said goodbye to his friend the dinosaur. And now, Danny decides to go to his home and tell his parents the adventures he had. Oh well, thought Danny. We don't have room for a pet that size anyway. But we did have a wonderful day. And look how wonderful that day is that Danny had, enjoying himself. So hopefully you enjoyed yourself too. And always, always, always be extra careful when riding a dinosaur. I think that's the most important part of the story. If you see a dinosaur, don't ride it unless you know it's your friend. Thanks for watching. Thanks for hanging out. Thanks for enjoying the book. I'm going to read other books and put them up for you. This is one of my favorites, Danny and the Dinosaur. You can subscribe below. You can show them to your kids. I'm never going to say anything bad because I have kids of my own and that's why I'm doing this. So I don't have to read them over and over again. So there you go. It's the story of Danny and the Dinosaur. Story and pictures by Syd Hoff. It's an I Can Read book. I encourage you to get one and read it yourselves.